Hi everyone, it's Hazel. I'm a CKD patient for 12 years. I was initially diagnosed at stage 3 and currently I'm at stage 4. So welcome once again to another smart recipe. What is a smart recipe? If you are new to my channel, a smart recipe stands for specific, modified, achievable, realistic, and timely. A smart diet is basically a diet that fits your individual needs. It is designed to meet your current condition, meaning what stage you are and what your current numbers are, such as your creatinine, BUN, EGFR, and the other compounds in the renal function panel. Also, if one has a protein in the urine, what is the best diet? A low protein diet might be best. Now moving on, I decided to share to you 5 oatmeal recipes because of a comment written by Miss Len Mendoza. So Ms. Len Mendoza requested if I can make some lunch and breakfast recipes. So I thought these recipes might be great. So to Len Mendoza and all of you who are struggling to prepare for your meal, I hope these recipes will help. I see some comments expressing frustrations on what to eat. I do understand your feelings when it comes to what food to eat, what food is best for the kidneys. With that being said, kidney patients don't have a lot of food choice. Everything has potassium in it. Everything has phosphorus. So sometimes it's really very frustrating. And honestly, I myself eat the same food over and over all the time. So what do I do? How do I prepare them? I try to be creative in making my recipes. So in today's video, I will share 5 different ways on how to make an oatmeal, whether you're making it for breakfast or for lunch. And you can also be creative. So in the beginning, I was not an oatmeal fan, but quite frankly, it's not so bad. It's actually delicious, and it's been my breakfast ever since I became stage 4. I actually eat it 2 to 3 times a week. So here are my 5 oatmeal recipes. So make sure to watch till the end of the video and let me know in the comment box what you think of these recipes. Let's start. First, oatmeal with berries. Our main ingredient is oatmeal. We need brown sugar, cut up strawberries, and blueberries. So this is very quick. Simply pour your oatmeal and then some hot water. Let the hot water sit for a minute or two, and when it's ready, just pour your brown sugar, drop in your strawberries, and of course your blueberries. These 2 berries are great for the kidneys. You can also use raspberries or blackberries if you want. Top it with more berries and enjoy. Next is oatmeal with apple and maple syrup. Cut up the apples in tidbits, prepare brown sugar and a pinch of cinnamon. Add the sugar and cinnamon once the oatmeal is ready. Pour in some apple tidbits, then mix it all up. You can add more apple tidbits on top and finally drizzle some maple syrup, just a teaspoon. The third recipe is inspired by piña colada. We need fresh pineapple tidbits, not canned, and fresh young shredded coconut, not frozen or not dried. And by the way, in all these 5 recipes, I only use 1/3 of oatmeal and 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, or maybe 1 teaspoon. It all depends on you. And of course, by this time, you already know the basic, just oatmeal and hot water mixed together.
And when that is ready, just add your fresh young shredded coconut, your pineapple tidbits. Then for the final touch, sprinkle some brown sugar, and that's it. Now, let's take it to the next level and create a lunch recipe. This next recipe is inspired by a popular Filipino dish called Ariscaldo or rice porridge. In this recipe, I'm using some moringa leaves, minced garlic, some ginger, and diced onion. So in this recipe, one cooking strategy that I want to share to everyone is I use a skillet that I have used to make fried chicken. I want to get the flavor from the chicken, so I pat dry the skillet with paper towel just to get the grease out. The bouillon or the brown stuff is going to make this dish flavorful. Just simply saute your onion, ginger, and garlic. Add water because I don't have a chicken stock. So using this spatula, I'm just going to scrape the bottom of this pan. I'm going to cover it for a few minutes and let it simmer. And when that is ready, you can add the oatmeal. I'm also going to season it with a teaspoon of fish sauce and some ground black pepper. Once the oatmeal is cooked, sprinkle the magic of moringa. You can use some scallions or any low potassium green vegetable. Serve with hard-boiled egg white and squeeze some lemon to enhance the flavor. Finally, we have oatmeal with egg white omelette and pico de gallo. So we need egg white, minced garlic, and diced onion. Again, 1/3 cup of oatmeal. And I have already prepared my pico de gallo or salsa. If you want to learn my recipe, you can watch my video that has the title of 5 egg white recipes. So using a small saucepan, saute your minced garlic and onion, pour the oatmeal and add some water. In this recipe, I want the oatmeal a little bit thick. Serve on a plate with the salsa and the white egg omelette. This is absolutely delicious.
That's all for our 5 oatmeal recipes for today. I hope you try them all and let me know in the comment box down below which one is your favorite. And if you haven't, make sure to subscribe and don't forget to click that bell so that you can be notified whenever I upload a new video. And don't forget to share to your friends and family. So thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time. And always remember, love your kidneys.